Well, hello everybody. This is Lisa from Stansbury Glass Art Studio. And today I'm gonna do a little something way different. You know how I love to video things that I'm totally not comfortable with and that I've never done before. So why not make a video of it and just make a complete fool of myself in front of the whole world? But here we go. So what I've done is from the Glass Pattern Quarterly magazine, one of my favorite Tucson instructors, Alyssa Fiel, showcased doing these very whimsical cactuses. I just fell in love with them. And now I'm going to be, this is my first one that I made. So I see things that I can do differently, but that's for another video. So I'm going to be mounting this on this canvas that I've added this little friend for my cactus, right? And I'm going to be covering this canvas now in resin. And that's what this video is going to show me attempt to do, because I've never done it. So we'll do that. And the idea is once the resin dries, then I'm going to put some little standoffs on top of the resin so this piece stands a little bit away from the canvas, just to give it a little more depth. And then it'll all get framed up, and that'll be at the end. Hopefully I'll show you. So let me get set up with everything we're gonna need and we'll get started. Okay, so before we actually get started, I wanted to go over some of the things that you absolutely have to have. One thing is if you have cats in your house, right? You definitely want an area where they don't go or have never been, because you don't want cat hair. And believe me, you think you have a clean house, you don't if you have cats, you know that. There's cat hair everywhere. So you really want to, first off, limit that piece of it. The other thing is of course you're going to protect your workbench. I have like 5-6 layers of newspaper underneath here. I also have underneath my canvas, I have some lids from my Fritz that help me, that'll help so the canvas is not sitting directly on that newspaper. Now I've messed up my shot. Okay, you're gonna need, of course, let's start with the resin. So this is what I got. I got this stuff from Home Depot. It's supposedly crystal clear. You want crystal clear, high gloss. I got a small box because, you know, this is the first and maybe the last that I ever, and it'll go on the shelf for years. But anyways, so this was recommended by Home Depot. This goes on, they use this for bar tops, and so you definitely want to make sure you have crystal clear for this project. And so what's in the box are these two. So you have, sorry, you have the actual resin itself, side A resin, side B hardener, excuse me. And what you're going to do is you're going to do equal parts. Doesn't matter what your ratio is or what your end amount is, as long as it's 50% hardener, 50% resin. Okay. You have the cups to do the measuring. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do 1 full cup of hardener, 1 full cup of resin. Okay. And then I'm going to pour them both into this cup. Excuse me, for stirring. And you need to, and so you'll need to have stir sticks, okay? And that'll, stirring needs to be approximately 5 solid minutes. So I will go get me a timer, because sometimes I get impatient and I won't give it the actual time it needs. And then, you know, we don't want this project to fail. So, and then lastly, what you'll need is either a heat gun. A friend of mine uses a, I use this. What this will do, either a heat gun or a torch, one of those cooking torches. Once you get your resin all spread out and it's in place, you want to make sure you give it some heat. And we'll go over that when it's time to bring up the bubbles that's going to be created, especially when you're stirring this stuff for 5 solid minutes. Okay, I think, oh, and I got rubber gloves. You don't want that stuff on you. I got an apron on. I got safety glasses on. Let me just go over the box. Not that I read the instructions, because I really just talked to my friends and I'm going to roll with this. But I don't see, other than, you know, you don't want to get this stuff in your eyes for sure. And you don't want to get it all over your workbenches either. So with that, okay. So let me go get a timer and then we can get started with this. So I'm going to start off by pouring equal amounts. I'm going to go up to that line there. Stop. Okay, that's the hardener. And now for the resin. So I'm basically going to go up to the same little line that I went for the hardener. I hope this works out. Because this is kind of like, I am way outside my, a little bit more. Okay. I'm going to put the correct lids here because I actually have them color coded for a reason. Okay. So as you can see, I have equal parts, correct? Can y'all see that? I barely see that. Okay. I have equal parts, and I'm going to pour them now into this cup here. And I'm going to try to get every as much as I can, because wouldn't it be a shame if I didn't guesstimate right, and I didn't have enough to complete this entire canvas. Okay, and then in with the hardener. Oh yeah, I think this is going to be plenty. And I forgot to get a timer. So shame on me. I turned the camera off and I got so excited about getting started that, honestly. So now I'm just going to stir it. I hope you can kind of see that. It is getting a little cloudy. Okay, I've been stirring for 5 minutes, and as expected, it has turned clear, and there's an incredible amount, I don't know if you can see this, of tiny little bubbles, which is to be expected, okay? So, let's go ahead and get the canvas down. Check my shot, that's pretty good. And so I'm going to just slowly start pouring. Oh my God, you guys, I'm scared to death of this. Don't ask me why. It's just a one canvas with a little bit of paint on it. So I had to do like, because I haven't painted in years, right? All right, so now I've got this. So I'm basically going to just take my stick and start spreading this somewhat even. This is supposed to be self-leveling. So when I make these lines with the stick, they eventually will work themselves out with, especially with the heat gun. And I'm just going to kind of go with the paint strokes that I put on here. But anyway, I used to be a painter. I used to do a lot of oils, a little bit of water, a little bit of acrylic, but mostly oils. And I don't know. I was in Iraq for 15 months, and I didn't take oils with me, but I did a little bit of painting, you know, and when you're in, oh gosh, I'm making a mess here. We have these walls that we were able to, you know, paint our unit stuff on, and so I did a little bit of painting with that, and that was fun. It was not serious at all, right? But I just kind of said to myself, I'm just bored to tears with painting. I don't want to paint anymore. So I haven't painted in years. And so I had to do, like, if I showed you, you'd laugh. I did a whole study just on making whimsical clouds, right? Because, you know, I didn't really want a Bob Ross type of serious cloud for this. And whimsical is not something that I've really done a lot of. So anyways, I took a canvas like this and just started clouds after cloud after cloud. You want to definitely make sure you get a full coverage. And I can see without the stick, I might not have full coverage on these corners. So I'm going to make sure. Gosh, I think I'm going to use everything that I mixed up. Make sure you get the corners. And just for fun, I'm just going to go ahead. Because the cactus is going to cover up a lot. So I'm going to make sure that I have covered, good coverage. Right there, I can see that there's little spots that are not getting. And it probably would help if you, like, got down eye level with it so you can really see where. Coverage is lacking. Okay. Now we're going to go, although I don't see a huge amount of bubbles, I'm going to go with the heat gun just for fun to say that I did. So it might get a little loud here. I'll use my left hand because, okay, cover your ears. We're going. Think. Oh yeah, you can see the bubbles just kind of coming up immediately and popping. You don't want to take this gun and just hold it in one spot. What I'm doing, I'm seeing as it's leveling itself out, it actually creates little spots of bareness, I guess. And my focus is going to be the cloud and the upper sky and the side skies. I want to make sure cover. Okay, I'm going to be done with the heat gun, and I'm just going to look. Now, this thing is probably hot, so I'm going to, as you can see, I mean, you can't see, I'm going to set that up like that. Let me move that so you can see My heat gun stands up by itself, just like that, because the tip of that, oh gosh, what a messy, sorry. The tip of that heat gun is super hot. And if you put it down, you're gonna catch something on fire. So we don't want that. Actually, you guys, I'm gonna leave this. It seems to be like, the beauty of resin is like, if this dries and I'm not happy with it, or you can always put another coat on. So it's too easy. And as you can see, like for a canvas, this canvas is 11 by 14. Two little green cups, one of each, is perfect. I couldn't have planned that any better. So I'm going to pause the video for now, and we'll come back when this thing is dry. Okay? Okay, so the resin has dried overnight, and as soon as it got to a point that I could, I took it down to Hobby Lobby. So this is the resin. It's really hard for me to be able to capture this, how crystal clear this is, how it looks like I've got glass sitting on top of this canvas right now. I'm really super happy with it. But what I wanted to show you is I took it down to Hobby Lobby. I had them basically frame this thing up for me. And what they do is they inserted the art. Then they put the little staples in it to hold it in place once they put foam board behind it. And then they put this dust cover on top, slap some a hanger on it. What I really like, and I've never done this myself, is see how they put the angles on that? That is awesome. I never thought to do that before. But anyways, they do a very professional job. They put little bumpers on the bottom there. So basically what I'm doing with this now is I'm gonna let this sit. I just wanted to show you so I could get this video out. Let me see if I can, I don't know if I can, if I freehand this, if you can see, you know, my main focus, oh my gosh, look at that. Beautiful. One thing I will say is that, to let this dry overnight, you really, I mean, I was so worried about cat hair, but over here, you see I have this lovely little Navy Federal, go Navy, right? Well, a fiber came off of this towel and ended up in here. You won't be able to see it on camera, but I found it. I am going to be covering that, luckily, with the glass sculpture. So I'm not going to worry about it, but, you know, there's more to worry about than cat hair, I guess. My daughter, who does work with resins, suggested that if you have like a big Tupperware, something clean that you can, you know, like an umbrella to put over this for while it dries, be good to go. Okay, so I'm going to set this aside and take this project one step further. Okay. And so what I'm going to do is, even though this part of it is really has nothing to do with the resin portion of it, it kind of does, because what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put, let me bring this over a little bit so you can see it. Sorry. I think you might be able to see it better without that. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, usually I use like acrylic tubing, but that gives it a really strong standoff. And I don't really want that strong. I just want a little bit. So I'm just going to use clear glass, and I'm going to epoxy it, two-part epoxy that to the back of the glass, let that dry, and then I'm going to apply it to the canvas. Okay. So let's do this. The two-part epoxy that I'm using. Is this stuff here. It's called JB Clear Weld. And I get it at Home Depot or probably Lowe's or probably Walmart, anywhere. Literally, every time I see this stuff, I buy it because I go through it like crazy. So it comes in a two-part syringe. So you just want to give it equal amount of pressure. So can't see it, but this is basically the hardener side. This is the resin side again. And you just want to give it equal amounts in the cup. And then we're going to stir it up and make it happen. So if you see it coming out one side, not both, just let up on the syringe and just squeeze that one side. Okay. Somewhere there's a cat. I'll get it in a minute. Anyways, I just got a little tiny bit in there. I'm going to stir it up because, again, you want the hardener and the resin to be well stirred, equal amounts. Smells horrible. Works great. I hope I got enough here. I might have to do some more. So, I'm going to start with this big piece here, right? I'm just going to slather it on this big piece. Kind of got to work fast with this stuff. This stuff dries a little bit quicker than the other resin that I... Okay, I am going to have to mix up more, but that's okay. Now I'm going to place it kind of in the middle of this, but at the same time, I don't want it to be seen. Okay, I'm going to apply just a little pressure to get any air pockets out. Mix up a little more. Okay, stirring more. Let's go with this big piece here first. And I'm going to just apply it in the middle and then kind of move it out. And then place it on the project. Let it sit for a second. I'll get this other piece going. Okay. And that is that. So I'm going to let this dry. And then, I'll show you the finished product at the end of this video, okay? I hope this helps somebody. If you've worked with resin, acrylics, glass, and put them all together, leave a comment down below and talk about your project. Let's all learn from each other on this because we're starting to, I can see this is not, we're starting, you know, in, well, I'm starting in areas where I've never been before. So if you see that I did something wrong or I could do something better, please leave your comments. I would just really appreciate it. Anyways, y'all have a great day and glass on. Bye. Okay, here's the finished product, y'all. Now, remember, the resin is the point of this video. So really, I just wanted to put it on the turntable to show you what the resin can do for your acrylic paints. I love it. Really, like, just makes the colors so vibrant. I mean, like, look at that little cloud. Oh, okay. All right. Thanks, y'all, for watching. I really appreciate it. Bye.